Stalin came to power on the death of Lenin and ruled the Soviet Union by fear and torture for nearly the next 30 years. During that time, he was responsible for some 40 million deaths. Stalin spent his first years in power consolidating his position. He managed to sideline Trotsky, whom he perceived as his major rival, and later had him arrested in exile. In 1929, Stalin implemented a policy known as collectivization. Lenin's experiment in nationalizing the land had remained half-finished, and Russian peasants were still working their own land and selling their own produce in the market. By means of collectivization, Stalin meant to complete Lenin's initiative and to take away all the peasants' lands and produce in the name of the state. Collectivization began with propaganda films. Posing on tractors, Stalin played the role of a leader who would lead Soviet agriculture towards a new dawn. Russian peasants were shown celebrating communism in front of posters of Karl Marx, and even dancing with happiness. Yet the truth was very different. In 1930, peasants' produce began to be collected up. The Red Army, one by one, seized the produce from every single field. Some peasants managed to hide their goods rather than give them up. But Communist Party officials searched every nook and cranny, eventually discovering the hiding places. Officials also seized the peasants' agricultural equipment. The peasants were left with nothing to eat and nothing to work the soil with. Eventually, that catastrophe that Lenin had described as the most useful for communism raised its head again and found. In Ukraine alone, 6 million people starved over the next few years. 2 million died in Kazakhstan, and 1 million in northern Caucasus. Children reduced to skin and bone died in agony. There was another ghastly result of the famine inspired by Stalin: cannibalism. Peasants maddened by hunger began to eat corpses. Then an even worse horror emerged. Some peasants had kidnapped children and eaten them. In front of these two Russian peasants, caught eating human flesh, lay the remains of the children they had snatched. Stalin's regime had turned human beings into savage animals, just as communism had intended. Everyone who opposed Stalin's collectivization policy paid with his life, The principal target were the landowners known as kulaks. Posters denigrating the kulaks were put up everywhere. Tens of thousands of kulaks were detained and shot. In actual fact, the regime branded everyone it saw as opposed to its ideology as kulaks. Large numbers of priests and even members of their congregations who attended church frequently were arrested as kulaks. Some were executed. Others were sent to the labor camps, where a slow, lingering death awaited them. These camps were set up all over Russia and were simply another of Stalin's killing machines. Millions of people regarded as enemies of the state were worked to death in them under the most terrible conditions. Some were put to work laboring on canals in the blazing heat. Others were sent off to break rocks in the freezing cold of Siberia. These people, forced to perform hard labor under the worst possible conditions, soon turned into living skeletons. The great majority never left the camps alive. Joseph Stalin was delighted by all this. In a speech to the Communist Party Congress in 1934, he declared collectivization to be a great success and was warmly applauded by the delegates. One by one, Stalin's closest associates took the floor and declared what a genius he was. However, a secret vote at the end of the Congress produced an entirely unexpected result. Out of the 1,900 delegates, 300 voted against Stalin. Stalin was stunned. The ballot forms were immediately collected and burned, and the vote declared invalid. It was then announced that Stalin had been unanimously elected Secretary General of the Communist Party. This was not the end of the matter, however. Stalin decided that that treachery would not go unpunished. About 1,000 of the 1,900 delegates were killed within a few months by Stalin's secret police, the NKVD.